In order to understand well many of these objects and the social communication, you require words and sentences. Sound. The sound is produced from the human organ and it begins with A. Every language begins with A. Sanskrit begins with A. Tamil begins with A. English begins with A. A is also the same thing, it's Roga. So, A to Sha in Sanskrit is called Aksharam. A to Akaradi Shakarantam. Na Akari I Uwe. Ka Tha Ga Ga Na. Cha Cha Ga Ga Nya. Ta Ta Ga Ga Na. Like this. Ya Ra La Ra Ya Na Na Na. Sha. Kadasila Varu Sha. So, all beginning and ending with Ksha is called Aksharam. That is, individual sound value, this is what we call phonetics. In Aksharam, in Sanskrit, is called in Prakrit as Akkaram. The conjunct consonant becomes a single consonant. It, Ksha, becomes Ta. So, Aksharam becomes Akkaram. Akkaram in Tamil, used in poetry, becomes Akkaram. So, when Thiruvalluvar begins his text, Agara Mudala Elithulla, Agara is actually the beginning of Akshara. What is this beginning of Akshara? How to teach it to the children? You start teaching the children from A. A. I. E. Like that. And every Hindu, that's what the stages of growth. The earliest stage of growth is teaching the phonetics to the child. I. It is called A. Ksha. Ra. So, the rite which is celebrated as a festival is Aksharabhyasam, Aksharabhyasam, practicing pronouncement, phonetic system, understanding phonetic system, learning it. And this is taught by our Veda. Taittiriya Upanishad is a part of the Veda. In that you have three sections. The first section is called Sikshavalli, teaching children how to pronounce. That is Sikshavalli. So the entire sound system, phonetic system in the Vedic period, which is about 2000 BC or 4000 BC annual, is based on this Akshara understanding, Akshara Abhyasa. And that Akshara Abhyasa is taught to the children all over India, for Hindus, boys and girls, at the age of 3 or 4. Amma. Amma. You teach the children. So, this is the first sutra is called Varnasvaraha. It consists of two words, Varnaha, Svaraha. Varnasvaraha is the first sutra. The second sutra is Matra Balam. The third sutra is Sama Santanaha. So, the entire sound system has been reduced by the Vedic scholars, Vedic rishis, into these two sutras. What is the meaning of Varna? Varna has got two aspects. One is prosaic, uttering phonetic sound. That is a shah. But there is another system of communicating emotion. Is music. Music has got varna. What is this varna? Is sa ri ga ma pa ga ni. This is the seven notes, what you call notes in music, is varna. Then these are pronounced on a very level, equal level. The equal level of pronouncing it is not sufficient. You have to go, ah, it's a, ah, ka, up, upward pitch, middle pitch, and lower pitch. So this is called swara. This is called swaram. High pitch, middle pitch, and low pitch. It's called swaram. Varna swaraha. So this teaches you about how to pronounce it on level, high and low pitches. Varna swaraha. It can be used for prosaic pronunciation or musical pronunciation. Both, two. The second is matra. What is matra? It is the length of the sound. Double matra. A is one matra. A is two matra. This is sufficient for prosaic uttering of words. But in music, you need it more. You can So it goes on into four, five matras. This is called the matra. This is horizontal evolution or pronouncement of the sound. So you have vertical movement of the sound and horizontal movement of the sound. This is called varna swaraha matra. How do you get the sound matra? Why? Pumping out more gas from your body, from your organ, from your vocal cord. So this is called balam, the strength. The strength you give to it, it goes on, particularly in music, when you have to take the swara, long swara. You need long matra. So this requires the balam. The strength you have, that much you can have. The sound communication. So you have varna swaraha, matra, balam. The third one is these sounds, individual sound, a, ka, ja, cha, sa, ri, etc., are combined into words. Words. Amma is combination of words. Up. Pa is combination of words. So combining words and combining the words into sentences is called sama. And that pronounced in a rhythmic way is sama. So when we say sama, it means musically rendering the sound in words. And then when you put all of them together, it is called samhita, samhitai, put together, samhita, that is called samhita. So, the earliest Hindu literature, the Veda, the Upanishad, which is the Taittiri Upanishad, in its first chapter, tells you how to pronounce the sound, how to pronounce the pitches, how to lengthen the sound, how strength is required to lengthen the sound, how you put all these sounds into words and sentences, and how you rhythmically sing it. All these are then reduced to three simple sutras that varna swaraha. Matra, Sama Santana. This is the origin of understanding either the world or the emotion. The world is prose. Sama is music. So through both you understand the world and the emotion. This is the concept of understanding the emotion.